Good morning, all of you. My name is Karthik Kumar, and the subject related to chemistry. Class for that topic is 6th class. The chapter name is Oxidation and Reduction. Oxidation and Reduction. Before entering into the chapter, we have to know some basic information about the oxidation number. Now, in the previous classes, we discussed how to write the electronic configuration of the given elements depending upon the rules. And what are the various rules we discussed in the earlier classes. Now, coming to the oxidation number, what is called the oxidation number? Oxidation number is also known as oxidation state. Coming to the definition of oxidation number, the charge on the atom in the given compound, is considered as oxidation number or oxidation state. Now, valency is equal to the oxidation number in some cases. Valency gives the combining capacity, nothing but only the number of atoms surrounded by the particular atom. Now, in case of oxidation number, it gives the charge of the atom, nothing but whether it is positive or negative. That is the definition of the oxidation number. Oxidation number purpose, to identify the valency of the atom in a particular given compound. Now, how we know the oxidation number of the particular element? For that, we have to learn the rules. Rules to know the oxidation number or oxidation state. Now, in that way, oxidation number of an element in native form, nothing but element availability in that particular form. Native form is always equals to zero. While taking an example, H2 hydrogen gas, colorless gas. Now, in case of hydrogen gas, the oxidation number of hydrogen in that particular element is zero, because of 2H equal to zero, this is a neutral atom, 2H equal to zero, then H also will get the zero. The same way, oxygen molecule, nitrogen molecule, chlorine gas, bromine gas, iodine molecule, P4 molecule, O3 ozone molecule, acid, sulfur molecule. In all the cases, the element in the particular molecule is having the oxidation number 0. 2Cl equal to 0, Cl also 0. 2Br equal to 0, then bromine atom also will get the charge, nothing but oxidation number is 0. In the same way, iodine molecule also 0. P4 0, O3 0, SI 0. Now, sulfur oxidation state in that SI molecule is 0, but sulfur valency is 2. Now, in this case, sulfur oxidation number is not equal to its valency. Is not equal to its valency. While taking the one more compound, that is CO2. In that CO2, the oxidation number of carbon is not equal to zero, because the given compound is a heteroatomic. It contains two different kinds of atoms. What are the two different kinds of atoms here? One atom of carbon, two atoms of oxygen. Hence, carbon gets the oxidation number with respect to oxygen. with respect to oxygen, not at individual form. Now in this case, carbon will get the charge plus 4, and oxygen gets the charge minus 2. We'll know that particular rule in the coming term. Now, oxidation number of an element in ionic form is equals to its charge. For example, while taking the ionic compound NaCl, it may divide into Na sodium atom, Cl chlorine atom. Now here, sodium loses one electron and it may transfer from sodium to chlorine. Then sodium gets the charge plus 1 sodium ion, chlorine gets the charge minus 1. Therefore, the oxidation number of sodium is plus 1, oxidation number of chlorine is minus 1. In the same way, while taking the ionic compound MgO, magnesium gets the charge plus 2, oxygen will get the charge minus 2. Magnesium is a metal, it is electropositive in nature. Electropositive in nature tends to form cation, which is the charge plus 2. Then the oxidation number of magnesium is plus 2 and its valency is 2. Now oxidation number of oxygen. Oxygen is an electronegative in nature, will gain the 2 electrons to satisfy the octet rule, hence it may get the charge minus 2. In the same way, while taking AlF3 aluminium fluoride, aluminium is a metal and fluorine is a non-metal. Aluminium is electropositive element, fluorine is electronegative element. Then it may divide or ionize into the aluminium ion and 3 moles of fluoride. Then aluminium having the charge plus 3, hence its oxidation number is equal to plus 3. Fluorine gets the charge minus 1, hence its oxidation number is equal to minus 1. This is the second rule. Now coming to third rule, oxidation number of hydrogen is always plus 1. Example, HCl. Chlorine is a more electronegative nature and it is represented by delta minus, and hydrogen is more electropositive or less electronegative, nothing but delta plus. Then hydrogen gets the charge plus 1 and chlorine gets the charge minus 1. Similarly, in case of X represents halogen element, hydrogen halides. Now in all that cases, hydrogen gets the charge plus 1 and the charge of halide is minus 1. Now oxidation number of hydrogen is always equals to plus 1, except in case of metallic hydrides. For example, while taking the compound sodium hydride, NaH. Sodium is a metal, tendency to form the cation. Sodium loses one electron and it may transfer to hydride. At the time, then it may form H minus. The losing of electron from the sodium forms the charge plus 1. The transferring of electron favors the formation of ionic bond or electrovalent bond. Now similarly, in the same way, magnesium hydride MgH2. Now magnesium is a metal, it belongs to second A group. It is in the form of solid, its valency electrons are 2. Nothing but magnesium loses 2 electrons and the 2 electrons may transfer to 2 hydrogen atoms. Then it may form H. After getting 1 electron, hydrogen can form H minus, here also H minus. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 2. Then to satisfy the neutrality of the compound, then magnesium gets the charge plus 2. Now coming to the next rule, that is oxidation number of oxygen is minus 2. Oxidation number of oxygen is minus 2. We already know that oxygen in elemental form, its atomic density is 2. And it is in the form of a gas. Then oxygen gains 2 electrons to satisfy the octet rule. Then oxygen shows minus 2 in oxides. Now coming to oxidation number of oxygen, except in case of peroxides, and superoxides. Peroxides, O power minus 1 or O2 power minus 2. Peroxide is represented with the O single bond O with the charge minus 2. While taking an example H2O2, hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide structure is an open hook type structure. Then it may have the type of bond HOOH. Now coming to their chemical properties, that is electron negative nature. Then comparing to oxygen and hydrogen, hydrogen is less electron negative, that is delta plus, and oxygen is more electron negative, delta minus. Nothing but hydrogen loses a sharing with the one electron. Hydrogen transfers one electron, then it may form plus 1. And oxygen will gain one electron in this bond, then it may form minus 1. And with respect to O and O, there is no transfer of electron. Because electron negative difference is equals to 0, hence it is non-polar. No transfer of electron. Now here, hydrogen gets the charge delta plus because of low electronegative nature, and it may transfer one electron by forming the charge delta plus, that is plus 1, and oxygen gains one electron from the hydrogen, it may form minus 1. Now in this case, oxygen atom getting the minus 1 and minus 1 charge. Now one more example for this one, sodium peroxide, Na2O2. Or its topic is related to the oxygen. Now, and also in case of superoxides. Best example here, KO2. Now in this one, oxygen charges minus 1 by 2 or O2 power minus. Highly reactive metals doesn't available in the free form. It is always in the form of a combined nature. Then while it reacts with the oxygen or with the nascent oxygen, it may form the peroxides. Now coming to the oxidation number of 1A group and 2A group elements. Oxidation number of 1A group elements is always equals to plus 1, except for hydrogen. For hydrogen, we discussed already here, hydrogen shows plus 1. Because of the electropositivity nature of 1A group elements, and it also shows minus 1 with the electronegative nature of halogen elements. That is for position of hydrogen. Position of hydrogen is related to the 1A group as well as the 7A group. Hydrogen position in 1A group due to the electropositive nature and number of valence electrons 1. Position of hydrogen 7A group due to the electronegative nature, and it gained one electron to satisfy the stability rule. Now coming to second A group, all the elements in the second A group forms the charge plus 2 because of metallic nature. Now oxidation number of halogens, in interhalogen compounds, how can we know them? While taking an example, ClF3, chlorine trifluoride, ClF3. Now, coming to their charge, Cl gets the charge plus 3 and fluorine gets the charge minus 1. Fluorine plus 3 and fluorine minus 5. To satisfy the neutrality, plus 3, 3 into minus 1, minus 3. Plus 3 minus 3 is equal to 0 neutrality of the compound. Similarly, you are taking IF7, iodine heptafluoride. Iodine heptafluoride. Then you may find the iodine with the charge plus 7 and 7 fluorine atoms gives the charge minus 1. Now, after completing these rules, then overview of group elements. 1A group, as already discussed there, 1A group can get the charge plus 1. For that, the best examples are HCl, NaCl, LiF, lithium fluoride, etc. Now, in other cases, the 1A group elements are hydrogen gets the charge plus 1, and the sodium 1A group gets the charge plus 1, lithium 1A group gets the charge plus 1. Now, in the same way, second A group elements gets the charge plus 2, as earlier we discussed there. Then, the best example here, BeCl2, beryllium chloride. Beryllium gets the plus 2 charge. And its hybridization is sp hybridization. Sp hybridization, which is the structure, linear form. Linear form, shape is linear. Now, coming to the next example, MgF2, magnesium chloride. And in this case, magnesium charge is plus 2. Calcium oxide or quicklime. Calcium oxide or quicklime. Then calcium gives the charge plus 2. Oxygen gives the charge minus 2, as I mainly discussed that. Oxygen charge is always minus 2 in case of oxides. Now coming to third year group, starting element is boron. And its special name is boron family. 1A group alkali metal, 2A group alkaline earth metals, 3A group boron family. Its charge is plus 3. Now similarly, 4A group plus 4 as well as minus 4. 5A group, you may get the charge plus 5 to minus 3. Plus 5 to minus 3, because it may contain metal, metalloids, along with the some non-metals. Non-metals gets the charge minus 3, metals may get the charge plus 3, metalloids may shield the electron by forming the charge plus 5. Similarly, 60 group elements. For that continuation here, 60 group elements. Oxygen family. Nothing but while sharing it may form plus 6. And while losing it also forms plus 2, and while gaining it can form minus 2, plus 6 to minus 2. Rating of oxidation number for 60A group is plus 6 to minus 2. In the same way, for 70A group elements, as earlier discussed there, plus 7 to minus 1. Then for 8A group elements or 18th group elements or zero group elements or noble gases or inert gas elements may have the charge 0, except now recently experiments shows that xenon shows plus 2 in case of fluorides. Xenon shows plus 4 in dioxides, and its highest oxidation number, that is plus 8 in case of HCO4, xenon tetroxide. Now here the best example, hydrogen halides, we given already HX. In that X may get a charge minus 1. Now while taking a water molecule for 60 group elements, water molecule HOH. hydride charge is plus 1. Now here also hydride charge plus 1. Plus 1 and plus 1, because of electronegative nature, oxygen may get the charge minus 2. Minus 2. Now, in case of fifth group elements, NH3 ammonia. NH3. N3H, it is variable. Now, nitrogen shows plus 3 here. Now, hydrogen, N3H, hydrogen. Its oxidation number also will vary. Now, here it may have the charge 3 into plus 1, plus 3, N plus 3 equal to 0, N equal to minus 3. Now here 3n equal to minus 1, n equal to minus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 3. N power minus 3 is known as a nitride ion. N power minus 1 by 3 is known as a azide ion. Now coming to 4th group, it may have the charge of plus 4 as well as sometimes minus 4. Plus 4 for a carbon while sharing, minus 4 for carbon while gaining of 4 electrons, it may form C4 minus 4. Example, CaC2 calcium carbide. In the 3rd group elements, it may show plus 3. Further, the best example is BCl3, chlorine molecules 3. In that, the settled atom is boron with the valency electrons 3. Boron valency electrons are 3, then sharing each chlorine with one electron pair. The total number of electron pairs are 3. 3 into 2, 6 electrons. 3 electron pair, 6 electrons. It is electron deficient molecule. Electron deficient molecule. Nothing but able to gain an electron. Electrophile. Able to gain an electron. Electrophile. BCl3. Now in this case, boron gets the charge plus 3. Now, in this session, we discuss the oxidation number. It is one of the basic topic in the chapter oxidation and reduction reaction. The definition of oxidation number, how can we identify the oxidation number, and what are the rules. In the rules, oxidation number in elemental form, oxidation number in ionic form, oxidation number of hydrogen, plus 1 and minus 1, oxidation number of oxygen, minus 2 in oxides, minus 1 in peroxides, minus 1 by 2 in superoxides. Oxidation number of a particular group elements, 1A group element, plus 1, 2A group element, plus 2, respectively. Now, oxidation number of halogens, generally we get the minus 1 by gaining 1 electron, but in case of interhalogen compounds, it may get the different charges depending upon the surrounded atoms. With the particular surrounded atoms, then it may get the charge. Further, the example is given, chlorine trifluoride, iodine heptafluoride, and the remaining group elements, 1A group alkali metal, 2A group alkaline earth metal, 3A boron family, 4A carbon family, 50A nitrogen family are nitrogens, 60A group oxygen family are chalcogens, 70A group fluorine family are halogens, and last one, that is 80A group or 18th group noble gases may get the charge with oxidation number 0, except in case of some compounds. Thanks for watching.